Right now we have a male that went swimming at Inspiration Point in the channel, and a search came in, took him under. Friends couldn't find him. After a search, they called the Sheriff's Department and Fire Department. We responded out here. Unfortunately, right now at this stage, it is called a recovery, and hopefully they will continue to search and find the body. Initially, on a 911 call, the fire department will respond. At that point, it is considered still a rescue. After a certain amount of time, they now deem it a recovery operation where they can't find the body. When that occurs, then the sheriff's department comes in, and they will actually be the recovery, that recover the body.
How do we prevent situations like this in the future? What are some of the steps that maybe us as residents can take?
Right now, you can join NCSL. The Sheriff's Department, Fire Department, we put out NCSL alerts about the surf. The lifeguards are putting out tweets and NCSL, and also on Facebook. We'll put out the local surf forecast, especially with the lifeguards. It's just this past week with the storms in Australia, the surge came up here, and a lot of people were not prepared for it. And unfortunately, we've had two deaths in the past, 48 hours. You know, the family's here, and it's just absolutely tragic. So please, if you come down here, please, please be careful. One of the things you need to know where you're at, and that was a big deal on both of these incidents. They said they were near Abalone Cove. Well, you can see this is a big area. And so all the resources went to Abalone Cove when in fact it was Inspiration Point. So there, I mean, you're losing precious, precious time. So please know where you're at all times.